people just really enjoyed them. I think it was about handling the objects, the fact that they were museum objects, and that they were able to touch these, but also they brought back so many memories.
But more than just the people remembering things and being able to speak where they couldn't before, or being able to be happy about being in a place where they're safe to just live in that world where they were when they were a child, the people who were with them, family, husbands, wives, daughters, sons, and carers, we didn't realize how much it was going to affect them.
Some objects work really well immediately. Somebody will share a story with the group, or Gavin takes that object and uses it as a sort of starting point for one of his stories.
Things like the shaving brush. So we took that out, and maybe that's quite a mundane object to us, we've seen it before. But people remembered their father or even themselves sometimes using it. So we talked about what it was made of and how they used it, and how special it felt to use it.
I've never done this kind of thing before, where usually I'll use traditional stories or true life stories that live on the tongue, that they're memories, and I'd never write them down. Now I'm dealing with people's memories, and you don't want to lose any of these things. They're nuggets, they're jewels, really, and you want to give them back as a gift. So that's what this is. When I tell a story at the end, where I've gathered all the people's lives and worked them into a fantastical tale, and then I get to tell the story, and when I'm telling the story, I'm looking at the people's faces, and I see them light up when I talk about a memory or a place they've been to, or where they were married, or some experience, and the look on their face says, that was me.
The objects helped people to remember stories and memories, which Gavin could then put into the final story. And then they heard that, they heard their stories, and I think that was really important for people.
Not only were there the folks from the sessions, and you got that wonderful joy of seeing themselves in the story, but there were also people from wider dementia cafes who hadn't been part of the groups. But because of the themes of the suitcases and the eras we were talking about and the places people had been or the memories they'd had, lots of the things we talked about touched base with other people in the room.
Remember, you said one day that you'd like to go back to Worcester Museum itself and have a look at the things in the museum, because when we used to go to the group, we used to walk through the museum but didn't have time to look at the special items, did we?
What is value to someone who has dementia? What is value to someone who looks after someone with dementia? What's value to a carer? And those are the things that started to come out, that someone who has a family member to sit with other people who are in the same boat as them was just a respite and a haven, where at first they were tentative about coming to the groups, but connected with other people and have started to get together with those people and form relationships outside of dementia cafes.
It's nice interacting with the other people. And it was good that we have similar sort of memories. We've had similar experiences, and it brings back memories from all of us.